Gather the writers. It's time the world hears my life story.
Of course, sir. Even though I'm just the messenger, the ending to this story will entirely depend on the writer's skills. I'm sure the Harrodin Wells biography will be an instant bestseller. It's up to them now. Five writers, five books, and only one winner.
I'm so excited to finally meet you. I've read all your books cover to cover. Could you please sign my favorite one? So much. Would you mind posing for a quick photo? It would mean a lot to me.
Good morning. Before I introduce myself, I'd like your full attention. Why don't you check your bank account, and then we'll talk. I know this may seem like showing off, but your works have caught the attention of my employer. He would like to offer you the chance of a lifetime. My name is Rupert Wellmeyer, and I represent Mr. Harrodin Wells. I've traveled across the country to offer you a job. Mr. Wells is too frail of health to contact you personally, so he sent me. Right now, my job is to speak to his favorite writer in his name. Writers from all over the country will be competing to write Mr. Wells' biography. The winner will be published and paid handsomely. Thanks for accepting. Oh, one more thing. Could you sign this, please? Mr. Wells is collecting all of your first editions. Excellent. I'll give you a lift to your home so you can pack your things. Then I'll arrange a private flight to Mr. Wells' estate. I'm glad you joined us. The other riders we sent for should be here already. Mr. Wells' estate is secluded and peaceful, but it seems we're in for a storm. Hang on, it's gonna be a bumpy landing. I'll bring your luggage upstairs to your room. Please head to the parlor and make yourself comfortable. I'm going upstairs for Mr. Wells. He will be down shortly.
Adam, please. No disrespect, but your horror novels simply do not appeal to mature audiences. Mainly young adults read your Fantasmat series.
Says the guy who writes children's fantasy. The only mature audience who reads Hidden Expedition are the parents who read it to their kids.
Hey, aren't you Mrs. Douglas? You wrote the Dead Reckoning series, right? Could you find the average critic score and show it to us?
See, Adam? I told you. But don't worry. I'm certain you'll eventually get a horror movie deal for your books.
Oh, those two have been giving me a headache for the last hour. They're bickering like an old married couple. Do you have a lighter on you? I'm getting quite nervous around new people. You're a lifesaver. The name's Jessica Benedict. I'm sure you've heard of my Dance Macabre novels. I've read your work. You could say a few of them inspired me as well. Keep up the good work, darling.
Great weather out there, huh? Sorry I'm late. I hope I didn't miss anything.
So you're the author of the famous Off the Record series? It's a pleasure to meet you in person. To be honest, I pictured someone older.
I agree. It's exceptional how you've managed to publish so many books at such a young age.
Thanks. This is such a great opportunity for my career. I like journalism all right, but my passion is creative writing. You guys are the first people to see my face. I'm turning a new page in life. No more hiding from the public.
Welcome, my dear guests. It isn't fair that I know so much about all of you, but you know so little of me. So please, gaze at the wall behind you. My beginnings were humble, but with time and effort, my company grew into the industry leader of this country. I became rich at last, and used my wealth to travel around the world, meeting all kinds of people. Each day was better than the last. I threw a party every weekend, accompanied by the most beautiful women. In my heart, I've always been an adventurer. Extreme sports excite me, but my first love has always been music. I love concerts, so I built a stage in my backyard. Listening to loud music always gives me such a rush. Before I met my wife, I had my share of fun, even though I still grieve her death. That's when I secluded myself from the public eye. Now, I've prepared a gift for each of you, which can be opened only with a special token. They're at the bottom. Please help yourselves. I've selected each of you for your specific writing styles. My biography must be written by the best of the best. I will choose the writer whose outline I like the most. The book will be published, and the winner will get $500,000. But enough about that. First, I would like to propose a toast to all of my talented guests. Cheers!
What's going on? Oh no. Mr. Wells? Are you all right? Hang on, sir. I've got you. Once I have Mr. Wells secured, I'll call the police. Everyone, please, stay calm.
Adam? No! He's dead!
I'll try to contact the police now. It's admirable how you kept your composure. Hang on for a minute. Hello? I'm calling from the Wells estate. There's been a murder. Mrs. Douglas, could you examine Adam's body and describe what you see? I need to give the police as much information as possible. Our drinks were spiked with a sleeping drug, so we all fell asleep. When we awoke, we discovered one of us was dead. The victim was stabbed once in the chest and died almost immediately. The killer left a threatening note. We're all in danger. Please, send someone immediately. What? What do you mean? Oh, the weather. All right, but please, come as soon as you can. Well, you heard the news. The police will come as soon as the storm passes. Go to your room. It should be safe there. I'll be in my office.
Miss Douglas, Rupert told me what happened to Adam. I never imagined such a heinous crime could happen in my own home. I've locked myself in my room. I suggest everyone else do the same. You can find the keys by my late wife's portrait.
Yeah. I'm not in the mood for chit-chat, darling. Please, go.
Can you believe all of this? I feel like I'm trapped in one of Adam's novels. I just wish it would all end. Listen, Cameron didn't go to her room at all. I looked for her outside too, but I didn't see her. I don't know where she is. Also, I found her book. Check out the release date. There's no way she could have written it in high school. She's too young. Something is fishy. I know what you're thinking, but I didn't kill Adam. I'm familiar with his work, but I harbor no resentment. He was weird and paranoid, sure, but why would anyone want to kill him? Frank, I'm scared I'll be next. Forgive me, but I don't feel safe here.
Look, I've told you all I know. Please, just give me some space. I'd like to be alone.
Thank you. come. I took everything I owned and invested it into oil. I decided to sell it at a low price, and after a while it began to sell like hotcakes. At its peak, the Wells Oil Company held 90% of the market share for refined oil. We then invested in the airline industry, purchasing several jet companies. Years later, I divided the Wells Oil Company into several smaller ones, increasing their value and doubling my wealth overnight. Wells Investment was my next endeavor.
Thank you.
Please! Thank you. I'm Cameron Jones. I was getting ready to drive to a writing competition a few hours ago when I was kidnapped. What? That's impossible. I'm Cameron Jones. Someone knocked me out and locked me in my car trunk. If you don't believe me, check my ID. I'm the one who wrote that book you're holding. It was published back in 2000. The last thing I remember was putting my suitcase in my trunk when someone hit me on the head. The next thing I knew, I was kidnapped. I really needed money, so I decided to write a huge story about Mr. Wells' business. Isn't it suspicious that he got that rich so fast? Please, can you take me somewhere safe? I couldn't bear to face my kidnapper again.
Join me on the balcony. I need some fresh air. Oh, this has gotten completely out of hand. I'm so stressed that my asthma is acting up, but I can't seem to find my inhaler. Please, can you find it? I'll be waiting here.
Thank you.
I can breathe easily again. Thanks to you. Listen, I have something important to tell you. 10 years ago, I did something terrible. That was a gunshot. It came from Luca's room. The killer just escaped. He left a mess behind. I'll keep an eye on it. Who are you again?
I'm Cameron Jones. It's a long story.
Her story is the craziest I've ever heard. Take your fingerprints, just in case. Now we know who to look for. That girl imposter. Let me just get back to what I started on the balcony. Excuse me. Hello? Sir, Mr. Rutledge has been murdered, too. I'm doing the best I can, sir. Hello? Mr. Harridan is not feeling well. I'll explain everything later, I promise. I must go now.
I have a favor to ask. Can you check my room with me? Thank you. I think we're safe here. Just between us, my journalist intuition is telling me that Rupert is lying.
I don't have any proof, but you should investigate him.
Thank you.
You want to take my fingerprints? Sure. Lucas's what? Oh, yes. I visited him, but he was alive when I left. I've been here ever since. I was sick of waiting like a sitting duck. So I downed some caffeine and started researching. I'm not dying tonight. Harridan was quite the playboy. Did you know there's a hidden cave in this house? It's on these blueprints. Also, Virginia Westwood's book is a valuable first edition. It doesn't quite belong there, you know? I'll stay here and continue my research, if you don't mind. Thank you.
turn that camera off.
If anyone can hear me, help! Rupert attacked me, so I've locked myself in my panic room. The passage is by the aquarium. Hurry and watch out for Rupert.
Thank you. What's going on in this madhouse? It's time I come clean. My real name is Haley. I kidnapped Cameron to get closer to my father, Harridan. Rupert knew who I was, but he acted like he didn't recognize me. Then when I went upstairs after Adam died, bam! He knocked me out. Let's get out of here. I'll show you the passage where Rupert attacked me. It's over here, behind the bars, but it can't be opened from this side. It's over here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
it's my fault you lost your wife. But that young girl really is your daughter.
Don't toy with me. You bribed those puppets to be little Joanna's work, and she's gone now because of it.
You have to listen to me. I even did a DNA test. See for yourself. I hid it in the...
No, that girl is just another of your schemes. Now you'll have a chance to apologize to Joanna in person. I hope you're enjoying the show, Ms. Douglas. Please join me on the stage for the grand finale.
Thank you. I'm the villain here, Ms. Douglas. Just wait till you hear what I taped.
All right, I admit it. I wanted to inherit your fortune. That's why I got rid of Joanna.
You incompetent fool! I knew that all along. I've been planning my revenge for years. You were so naive that you didn't even notice I was faking my disability.
Thank you.
since Rupert took his final bow early, I had to improvise by making his accomplice take his place. You don't have to worry about your life. I brought you here to be the chronicler of this glorious night. What have I done? The process is irreversible, and this glass is bulletproof. The glazier told me this glass can only be broken with a specific frequency.
Thank you.
thank you for saving me. Well, again.
My dear, I don't even know your name. I'm sorry for everything. My pain blinded me. I'm ready to spend what's left of my life behind bars to pay for what I did.
Good work. Even an experienced detective couldn't have survived a night like that.
Harridan passed away, but not before he named me the inheritor of his estate. I'm so grateful to you for everything.